This is DJ Mag TV. In the spotlight this time, we have Akai's big black MIDI controller. The MPD32 gives everyone the chance to taste the MPC style of working alongside their own sequencer of choice. This USB power controller's got faders, switches, knobs, and those legendary MPC pads for tapping in the beats. It follows on nicely from their previous offering and features the same quality hardware and big blue LCD. It's not just a case of more controllers on offer this time, as it adds a load of new features in the programming department as well. It's nicely built with a metal frame underneath and a hard plastic top plate. It covers about the same area as a typical 15-inch laptop and is angled so that it's slightly higher at the back and sloped downwards. This makes it easier to read the LCD while sitting at a desk. It's reasonably light to carry around, and while it might be a bit on the big side, this is justifiable considering all the pads and controls you get on it. There are 16 full-size MPC pads to play with. These sit slightly higher than the MPC 2500, but we're really only talking about a millimeter or two, which isn't much in reality. Meanwhile, the feel of the rubber and the response of the pads are on par with each other. The pads have the same level of programmability, including global controls for sensitivity, curve response, and threshold. Individual pads can be set to note on or MIDI CC messages with a choice of momentary or toggle modes. You can have 4 pad banks or layers, which adds up to 64 different triggers in total. The similarities with the MPC range also include some of the programming modes such as 4 levels and 16 levels. In 4 levels mode, the pads always trigger at full velocity, regardless of how soft or hard you tap them. The 16 mode is different. This maps one sound across all 16 pads, and each pad has a different fixed trigger value, scaling all the way from 0 to 127 maximum. To enter this mode, press the pad you want to use as the root and hit the 16 level switch. Now you can play the sampler at fixed volume levels across all 16 pads. Both these modes have dedicated buttons on the right hand side. Another MPC trick is the note repeat feature. This works in conjunction with a row of time division switches underneath the faders. In this mode, the pads trigger notes in precise beat intervals from quarter notes to 30-second note triplets. When you synchronize to the internal MIDI clock, it works alongside the tap tempo button as a master controller. Akai have upped the number of faders on the MPD32 to 8. This is way more logical, as 8 is always a better number for mixing. You also get 8 rotary dials, which can be assigned to all kinds of MIDI functions. Like the pads, the number of possible assignments is increased by the use of 3 bank buttons, bringing the total to 24. Both the faders and the dials are very accurate to use, and it's a piece of cake to dial up an exact setting. There are 8 switches underneath the sliders. These are made from translucent plastic and are backlit with an orange bulb which glows when they're switched on. These serve a dual purpose and can be switched between MIDI mode and time division when using the MIDI note repeat function. You can choose between momentary or toggle modes for the switches. These always have 2 values associated with them. The maximum value you can define yourself, but the minimum value is always 0. Programming is quick and it's easy to access the essential parameters. It's not the deepest of MIDI controllers on the market, but should cover most producers' needs in the studio and live arenas. It connects via USB to the computer and is also bus powered. Also has hardware in and out ports on the back for connecting to other synths and samplers.